You can stand up here every Sunday and call everyone's attention for 30 minutes at the end of the senior meeting. Thank you. You imagine a soldier who is 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 Here we are digging away at the first bank today. And I pick up this stone. And Charles reminds me of the And I said to him, Charles, look at this, it's millions of years old. And I behold them again. And he turned to me and said, I'm sorry, Greg, but I can't believe that. I don't think it's probably been more than 2,000 years old. And I looked at him, and I said, what on earth are you talking about? And he said, it's a product of Noah's flood. And I said, you can't really believe that. No one believes that. So, just take it a bit further. Next morning, he's standing at the window, looking at it, and still thinking about what he said, and it's clear voice, looking at it, over my shoulder, and I pointed at it. On 17th of February 2005, sitting on the beach at the moon, I get this really strong message. My love and passion for God's creation must be true. And then, again in February 2009, I'm still trying to think about 2005, heaven. God reaches for his people with kindness, motivated by a deep and lasting love, eager to see the best for them, finally they will let them be with him. So if they're searching, stop with them, God, come in with his people. My word is joy, that's love, and I hope that they can see this, no matter what's going on in my life, and that's today.
Thank you.
have a problem. What is your life? As a Christian, you must simply be strong with the spirit of the Lord. But often, a person is not prepared to listen to what you have to say. But if I can simply give them something, if I can talk to them and get them to think about what they can never do to them, help them pick what prayers that God has spoken to them. And this is a tool to do. So this book is not about being speaking. I tried to put my photographs in it across to people who are visual. The photograph is what I was going to teach. But I found that the Lord would use the words in this book to lead me to it. He was never planned to be like this, but it was God's plan to be like this. It was so much of the Lord's work that was only in September last year. The next Stephen Boyd had this basic passage I had in my introduction, but it didn't work in my introduction. But it's like, if you give your heart to God, you need to perform with your words to God the good to ask Him to forgive you of your sin, and you need to stop doing that sin. And He reminded me that I had this in the book that was in my introduction, and it just didn't work. So much so, I'll read to you the very last parable that's in the book. The message is very close at hand. It is on your lips and in your heart. And that message is the very message about the Lord. If you open your prayer that Jesus is the Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by believing in your heart you have been made right. It is by openly declaring your faith that you are saved. This is scripture says, anyone who trusts in Him will never be destroyed. And that's the final parable. I had no idea how to finish this book. And it wasn't, as I said, until September last week. It's been a journey for me because I've prayed so much in preparing. So thank you. Thank you.